Okay, guys, the first thing I want you to do is to register for the Global Shipping Program, which will allow you to sell all over around the world, okay? Worldwide. You will be able to sell worldwide on eBay, which is amazing because most of the sellers that sell on eBay, they clearly say, and I agree with that, that about 50% of the profits that they make comes from international buyers. All right. So yeah, believe me when I say that you must be really interested in doing this. Okay. So come here to eBay. Okay. Just from eBay.com. Up here where it says hi and it says your name, come here to account settings, all right, and then click on site preferences here on account preferences, site preferences, all right. Then I want you to scroll down until you find shipping preferences. And then, yeah, we got it right here, Global Shipping Program. Its status says we are not enrolled, but we can just click on here by edit. And click on here just and say start now. Yes, add the Global Shipping Program to my active eligible listings. Continue. And that's all. We are already registered for this Global Shipping Program, which is amazing, you will see. And that should be all for this class. On the next class, we can configure, we can set up our business policies. So I'm going to talk about our business policies and how we can set up that in order to have everything configured in our account to start listing items in our eBay shop. Okay. So just click here and, well, hold here the mouse on your name and click on account settings. Then I want you to click on business policies, but yeah, it's not showing business policies yet. So just type on Google opt-in business policies on eBay. And you will have to find something like here, business policies on eBay. Okay, I will leave the link for you guys, which is this link, all right. And you have to come scroll down and click on where it says opt-in, okay? So you will finally find this page where you have to click on get started. And I don't know why it's showing this error message, because it should be working already. Yes, exactly. We just have to click again on business policies, and this is already done. Okay, so if I just update here, business policies, yeah, should appear here, yeah, down here, exactly. That's the proof that we are opted in on business policies already. So next thing I want you to do is create a business policy for payment, return, and shipping. All right, so let's start with payment, which is the easiest one. The under policy name, we just type default. And same for policy description, or you can put default payment policy. All right. And set as default payment policy. Okay. Check off this box where it says PayPal, and make sure to set up your PayPal email address. All right. On here. On exactly on here. Yes. And that should be all. You don't need to check off anything else at all. Would you just need to click on save? And that's all. Okay. We just created our payment business policy. All right. Next business policy I want you to create is return. All right. And the same, we can say default return policy. All right. Set as default return policy, okay, and you can leave it like this because 30 days is a good yeah, most of our suppliers like Walmart or Home Depot or Amazon, they are going to offer like 30 day money back, 30 day time to replace the item or to return the item. So this is, well, this is, yeah, this is well set up already. And if a return shipping, yeah, the return shipping will be paid by buyer, and same for international orders, okay? That's all, and click on save. And the last thing that we have to create is a shipping policy, all right? And shipping policy, well, we set the same, default shipping policy, default shipping policy, set as default shipping policy. And then here, okay, let's pay some attention here, because this, you are going to set up this depending on how your, on how long are you going to take, how long are you going to take to deliver the items to your clients. So let's go, for example, to Walmart and take a look on this supplier, because whenever we select any item that we want to list in our shop, and I will show you later how to do it, don't worry about that, you will see that for example, most of products in Walmart says arrays by Thursday on 17, okay? So most items in Walmart or most items in Amazon will deliver in the next five business days, for sure. Two or three business days, actually, yeah. From Amazon, they will deliver in one or two business days, especially if you buy with Prime account. So, yeah, I highly recommend you to start with this, start and standard shipping, 1 to 5 business days. This is great. And make sure to check off this box, okay? Free shipping, all right? And on handling time, you can put up to 3 business days. If you put more than 3 business days, this will be reflected in your item and it will be not attractive for buyers, okay? So yeah, just make sure to put 3 business days, and if you find that you can handle your orders in a faster way, then you can change this to 2 business days, okay? Or even to 1. But yeah, 3 business days is good to start with, okay? For international shipping, this, make sure that you have check this box, okay? Send it to the US shipping center and the rest will be taken care of for you. That is the way it works with global shipping program, okay? With international orders. You will just be sending the item to a US shipping center or to the US eBay shipping center, and they will take care of that. They will take care of sending the item to worldwide, to any other country, all right? So no international, no alternative international shipping, this is good. And this is, don't need to check off this, but I want you to click on here to create exclusion list, because most of your suppliers, and you need to make sure about this depending on the suppliers that you are using, but for example, Amazon or Walmart, they don't deliver items to Alaska or Hawaii, to US protectorates or to APO or FPO or PO boxes, okay? So I want you to click and exclude these locations, so you will not be delivering items to these locations. Make sure to check off these boxes and check off something else if you want to exclude your items to be sent to any of these international locations, all right? But there is no need for this, because yeah, most of the suppliers that you are going to use, they will be sending items worldwide without any problem, okay? eBay will take care of that. But just make sure to check off Alaska, Hawaii, US protectorates, yeah, and PO boxes and APO, okay? And apply that, okay? So you will have your excluding list here and click on save. And I want you to exclude this locations also in your shipping, yeah, on your account settings, okay, here, when you click on your here on your account settings, you may go now to site preferences. And we're going back to shipping preferences where we enrolled for global shipping program, because I want you to exclude the exactly the same locations here for the global shipping program, all right? So exclude Alaska and Hawaii, US APO, US protectorates and PO boxes, okay? So click on save to make sure of this. And if we come back and we just reload, yes. Make sure that you have this domestic three and international one of them. Exclude shipping locations for the global shipping program. All right. And with all of that, we already set up our business policies. So we are almost ready to start selling on eBay. There are some other things that I want you to set up, but that will be on the next class.